Hey, this is Rhys Fulber, and you're getting your fix from Metal Injection. Hi, I'm Rhys Fulber, and I'm here at my studio in Los Angeles, and I'm going to talk about five records that helped define my career as a producer, focusing on the heavier spectrum of music. Demanufacture by Fear Factory, which is, you know, a record a lot of people know. Through my work with Frontline, we eventually got picked up by Roadrunner, and then we got on their radar because they were looking for industrial mixes. We did the Fear is a Mind Killer remixes, which they were happy with, and which actually did all right in clubs and things like that, and sort of opened some new doors for the possibilities with death metal bands or whatever you want to call it. And so when it came time for them to make a new album, they asked me to come and contribute keyboards and samples. And what sort of happened with that record was it sort of evolved more from just putting keyboards into becoming more involved in the whole direction of the album. Colin Richardson had produced the record and had his idea of a direction, and the band kind of had a different idea of the direction, and they really wanted to push things further in a different way. And so we came back to LA after working on the record in upstate New York, and we basically remixed the whole record and pushed all the keyboards and electronics right up front. And at the time, it was kind of bold for a metal band to make something so electronic heavy, and obviously it worked out well for everybody. And that record really opened a lot of doors for me as well. You know, people kind of became aware of the possibility of you know, getting keyboards and electronics and metal music, and still it being heavy and still interesting. Caustic Grip by Frontline Assembly. It was the first professional record I made with Frontline, and the first record I made as a full-time member. Bill Lieb of Frontline had made another record with the other member, Michael Balch, and Michael had stayed in Chicago to work with the Ministry camp, and Bill needed to make a new record, and he's like, Michael, I think has moved on. I need to make a new record. Are you interested? As I had done some stuff with him before, but not on this level, I guess you could say. So I showed up, we bashed out a record in like maybe 6 weeks and went into Vancouver Studios to mix it on the SSL console, which was the first time Frontline had made a record in that capacity. Fun Metal Factoid is, as we finished the record at 9 in the morning after being up all night, we had to hurry out because Queensryche were loading in to do, I think it was Empires, it's like 1990, so whatever Queensryche record they started making in 1990, so we had to get the hell out of there because we were taking up their time. The next record is Obsolete, the follow-up to Demanufacture, which is different in the sense that I actually produced that record with the band. So we really got to see our vision through right from the beginning to the end. And because Demanufacture did well, we were allowed to work at a very high level of production, you know, in nice studios, really like no expense spared, every detail. Build the whole thing from the ground up, get the sounds we wanted. I started using modular synthesizers at that time, and the very first sound on Obsolete is actually that synthesizer right there, because I was patching drums and guitars into it. And I'm not sure how many people were using that type of equipment on metal records at that time. I know they used modular synthesizers in the 70s, but they sort of were re-released in the 90s, and I got into it right away, and it really, like, I mean, the first sound on the album on Shock is the drums put through that system there, and it was just a really good time of we were experimenting more than on D-Manufacture and expanding our palette of sounds. And like I said before, because we started with the vision we had and took it all the way through to the end and literally spared no expense on production. So that was a big record for the band in the end and for me as well, because it was a chance for us to really, you know, show the things we could do given the opportunity. Next record would probably be Symbol of Life by Pararise Lost. I'd been living in Europe in the 90s and became exposed to that band and became a fan instantly. I just really liked their sound, and I had met them a couple places on the road and talked to them a little bit, and I was more just a fan of the band, and I had told them that. They had me do one remix off the Host record, and then out of nowhere I got a call from them about producing. And I actually think Aaron, the guitar player, had suggested me because he had remembered us hanging out. And the band was going through a bit of a transition after, you know, they had really gotten to the upper reaches of metal, and they decided to try some different directions with their music that I don't think, you know, worked out really that well for them. And they were looking to sort of reboot their band and their sound, and you know, they were interested in using electronics, and I was actually more interested in them kind of being heavy again. So I think that record was a good transition for them, because I was trying to push it still more heavy, but of course I can still bring the keyboards and things they wanted. I would like to think that helped usher in them next stage of their career of making great records again and not being defeated from a couple records that didn't work out for them. And it's actually one of my personal favorite albums. I just love some of the songs on there with the their sense of dark melody. I really enjoy. A recent record, which is Youth Code, Commitment to Complication. I was on tour with Frontline Assembly and Skitty Puppy a couple years ago, and Youth Code were also on the bill. And I had heard about them through a couple friends and then watched them on the tour and immediately really liked their take on old school industrial mixed with hardcore and metal influences, and they had a lot of energy. Sarah's vocals were really powerful, and I became friends with them pretty quickly on the road, and then they had spoken to me about wanting to work on a new album with me, and I was really excited about that. It was sort of like a rebirth of some of the old industrial ways, but put into a new context with new people, new format. And it was just a really fun record to make, where I could kind of go back to some of my roots and then bring in this new energy. So it's not like you're recycling something from the past. It's like you're taking elements from the past and updating them and giving them this new modern take on things. And also Ryan, being from hardcore, is bringing in that other energy, and it's sort of like creating this interesting hybrid. I really like that record. Definitely re-triggered a lot of that stuff for me that I'm pretty happy with. Those were five records that I think were important in my career, and hopefully in the artists' careers as well. And I'm always working on new material. I'm currently working with a new band out of New York called Hogwash, with some interesting, heavy, industrial metal hybrid. And there's some other things coming down the road I can't talk about quite yet, but there's always something in the works.